Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new, welcome. And if you're back, kisses. My name is Rosie. And today I want to be sharing with you guys my law of attraction stories, things that I have been able to attract. And there are different things. I even made a list so that I wouldn't forget. And at the end of the video, I'm sharing with you guys some things that you can do so that you can also attract what you want into your life. And if you're a subscriber of mine, you know that not so long ago, I made a video on how you can make your vision board, and that way you can attract anything you want as far as goals or anything that you want to do in your life. So with this video, I hope to inspire you and share with you the things that I think that are amazing, and they just inspire me to keep attracting more and more things into my life. So without talking anymore, let's begin. So I made a list of things that I want to share with you guys so that I wouldn't forget, and probably I am forgetting a few things, but these are things that happened this year, and they're in no specific order, so I'm gonna begin with the first one. Okay, so one of the first things that I told myself was, universe, I want to meet a YouTuber, any YouTuber that I follow, but I just want to meet anyone. So one day we were walking in at Choices, which is a vegan place to eat here in Miami with my boyfriend. And as soon as I walked in, the first person that I saw there was Ronald, and he has a YouTube channel. It's in Spanish. I think he also has an English channel, and it's all about eating plant-based. And it was amazing. I was able to talk to him for a few minutes, and then getting back home or the day after, I remembered this is something that I had asked the universe to happen. I just wanted to meet any YouTuber, and I did, which is not common. So I was really surprised to have seen him, and I took a picture with him, and I shared that experience on my Facebook. Okay, the next one. Something that I wanted to attract was a job. So when I was looking for a job, I had a specific pay. I said, I want to earn this much at my job. I want my job to be part-time, and I want my job to be nearby so that I wouldn't have to drive a lot. So I get on a Craigslist and I started applying. The day after, guys, I get a phone call from that job, and it was related to photography, and I thought this is perfect because photography is a hobby of mine. I like editing photos, I like Instagram, I like blogging. What else could be perfect? So the next day, I get a phone call to have an interview, and I started working that same week. So it took me one day to find a job. And it all depends on how you think about it, and how you don't have to keep asking the universe, when is it gonna happen? How is it gonna happen? You just let things flow. You have to trust that it will happen, and that you will have that something that you want, and it's just gonna happen. So just whenever you're doing any of these exercises, just visualize that you are already in that position. Okay, the next thing that I have in my list is to have a boyfriend. So I was single for so many years, and I felt like I did everything that I could to attract a boyfriend. I felt ready. I did a list of things that I wanted in that person, and I went out on dates, but it never went to anything. And the time that I was finally enjoying myself being single, when I really accepted how things were, that's when I found a boyfriend. And that's one of the things that I learned, that when you want something, you just kind of have to let it go, let things flow. The universe will always find the right timing. So don't worry about that. The universe is doing all the back end work for you. You just have to ask and wait. It's kind of like when you go eat and you ask for a specific food on the menu. You don't worry about, oh, when is it gonna come? You just wait there, and you know that's the food you're gonna get, right? So try to remember that when you wanna attract something, just let things go and they will come to you. Okay, the next thing that I want to share were little exercises that I was playing with. I was just getting into this law of attraction, so this was a few years ago. I wanted to attract to my life flowers, so I don't have a garden to get flowers from, or I don't usually buy flowers from the store. So what I do usually at bedtime when everything is dark, everything is silent and quiet, and little Lynn is sleeping, that's the time that I have for myself to be in bed and either meditate or like to pray, or in this case I think about the things that I want to attract into my life. So here I am in my bed ready to go to sleep, but before that I started telling myself I want to attract into my life flowers. So this is the part where you have to be creative and have a mind of a child. So put all your senses into work, and you can do this with your eyes open or with your eyes closed. There are no rules about this. Just do whatever works better for you. And I was there in bed and I remember thinking and closing my eyes and saying, these are beautiful flowers. They smell so good. They have beautiful colors. I did that for a few minutes and I let it go. So I went to sleep. A few days passed by, and then my mom comes to me and she tells me, oh look, a friend gave me these flowers, do you want to keep them? And I was amazed. I had asked for flowers and here I am getting flowers. That was, like I said, a few years ago. And now this time, I believe it was last year or maybe this year, I think it was last year. Yeah, I wanted to attract a specific flower. This time I said, I want a white rose, because roses for me are my favorite flowers, but it has to be white. So again, I play with my imagination and I said, oh how beautiful these flowers, they are white and they are my favorite flowers. A few days later, I am here at a wedding reception and they had delicious food. The tables were decorated so nicely, and at the end of the night my friend tells me if I wanted to take a little vase of flowers with white roses. At that moment, I just said yes, and I didn't think about it much. But then when I get home, I remember this is something that I had asked. And I actually did a blog post about it, so I'm gonna link it in the description box so that you can check it out. And I have pictures. And it's amazing that whatever you put your mind into, it will happen. Another example that I have was a furniture piece. It's more like a container with drawers. At this apartment where we are, I don't have a lot of space, but even so, I like to find ways to organize my things and maximize space. So one thing that I wanted was to have that container so that I could have space to put away everything that I had started to buy for pens, pencils, for craft, and everything that was gonna be for little Lynn and for me. And so I went to the store Big Lots because I had bought that container there that I use for my clothes, and they didn't have any. And then I checked online, I checked on Amazon, I checked on eBay, I checked all over the internet, and I didn't find what I was looking for. In my mind, I really wanted to have that exact model that I envisioned in my mind, which had four small drawers on top and three big ones on the bottom, and I said this is the one that I want. So here I am in my bedroom, and again I visualized that, oh, I have this container, it's in my bedroom. So in my mind I'm thinking this is where it is. I envisioned that I would open and close the drawers and that I had it. A few days later, my mom calls me and she tells me, there's a container by the dumpster, do you want to keep it? It's like new. And oh my goodness, it was the same thing that I wanted to have. Coincidence? I don't know about you guys, but I don't believe in coincidence. I believe that everything happens for a reason, or if it happens, it's because you attracted that into your life. Okay, and one last example, because I could keep going on and on with examples and I don't want to bore you guys, but this one is with little Lynn to show you guys that this is something that anyone can apply, because we're all part of this planet, we're all connected to this universe. So my little Lynn had been asking me for days and days that she wanted to see an earthworm. So that's so funny to me. She wanted to see a worm, and specifically an earthworm, and I kept thinking, how on earth are we gonna see one? Because we never do. We do walk when I take her to school, or on her way back when I pick her up, we also have to walk, but it's mainly pavement, so you wouldn't see many worms. And nevertheless, earthworms, like, they're not common here, especially in the city. So here we are. One day we are coming back from her school, and in the middle of the sidewalk there's a moving earthworm. Little Lynn was so happy, and I told her, this is something that you attracted because you wanted to see. Look what you were seeing, something that, like I tell you guys, it's not common to see here. I never ever seen earthworms here in Miami, but here she is, and she's so happy. And we picked up the earthworm so that it would be safe on the ground by the side. So that's another example. So those are my story, you guys. But now I want to share with you guys things that you can do so that you can also start applying the law of attraction into your life. So number one, happy foods. I call them happy foods because these are foods that keep you healthy, and they will keep you in a positive state of mind and with a positive energy. And so that is fruits, veggies, smoothies, and juices. Everything that is alive, basically. Everything that is plant-based. And if you drink water, just make sure that it is purified water. And if you can, just add lime juice or lemon juice, whichever one, but don't add sugar. It won't have the same effect if you add sugar, but if you drink water with lemon or lime, that alkalizes the body, and it is so beneficial. So the next thing is meditate. So try to do meditation as often as you can. I know some people do it every single day. I like to do it at least once a week. And the time of meditation, it all depends on you. I know some people do it based on their age. So if you're 20, try to do it for 20 minutes. But you don't have to do it that way. Some people do it for 10, 15 minutes, whatever you can fit into your schedule, but as long as you meditate. And what you can do, some people focus on your breathing, some people like to think about positive things. So it all depends on you, whatever works best for you. Okay, the next thing, try to do yoga. So if you do yoga, if you do running, if you do Tai Chi, whatever it is, but something that keeps you in the right mood and that keeps you motivated. This will help you to stay focused and to keep your mind in a positive state. Okay, next would be entertainment. So anything that is like books or movies, like a documentary. So maybe you're already familiar with The Secret, which is really popular, but you can read the book, you can see the documentary, but there are other similar ones that you can see. And right now I cannot remember them, but I'm gonna either put them in the description box or link it in my blog post that I'm gonna do with this video. And I actually have this one here with me, The Source of The Secret, which I got from my sister, I believe, and I cannot wait to see it soon. And the last thing that I love doing so much is music. So try to listen to music that is either in 528 hertz or 432, which is at the vibration or frequency of the universe. So this is something that I love doing when I'm meditating, or if I'm having a stressful day, that I love listening to this type of music. I have a playlist which I'm gonna share with you guys. Or even when I take a shower at nighttime, I like having this music in the background, and I get out of the shower feeling in my Zen mode. I feel so relaxed and I feel so ready to go to sleep. So these have been my stories that I wanted to share with you guys. Hopefully I can inspire you that anything is possible, and try to apply the tips that I gave you so that you can also start attracting, starting today, things that you want to accomplish or things that you just want to have in your life. If there are other things that you like doing, or if you have any stories to share with me, I would love to hear from you guys. So if you have liked this video, don't forget to give a thumbs up, and you can follow me on different social media accounts like on Facebook, Instagram, Snapchat, anything that you guys have with the same name. Lynn Sire. So thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Kisses. Bye.